Islad has slammed Shahid Balwa as well as Vinod Goenka for their alleged involvement in the 2G scam and gotten a favorable ruling from the Bombay High Court as far as the winding up of its Indian joint venture is concerned. Avantika is joining us with more details. Avantika, first take us through the allegations that have been made by both sides.
Well, this was certainly a high-strung courtroom drama with allegations and counter-allegations being made by both parties. Now, do remember Etisalat DB is basically a partnership between Etisalat and Majestic Infracon. Now, Majestic Infracon is promoted by Shahid Balwa and Vinod Goenka. Now, let me just take you through these allegations. Now, Etisalat on its part says that there was a major breakdown of relationship between the shareholders, and the major reason for this breakdown was in fact the proceedings against Shahid Balwa and Vinod Goenka. They also add that, you know, Etisalat is majorly held by the UAE government and that the UAE government does not want to be associated with persons such as this. Now, additionally, they also say that the company has lost in excess of 3,000 crores on account of the Supreme Court ruling quashing the 2G licenses. Of course, Majestic Infracon on its part also came back with some allegations. They stated that Etisalat had in fact colluded with Citibank and Stanchart to file this winding up petition, and that it was in fact some secret and illegal handlings by Etisalat that had led to the business operations not rolling out as planned. Now, once again, Etisalat on its part came back with some counter allegations, saying that in fact all the daily decisions of the company were being taken by Goenka and Balwa and by officers that were in fact hired by them. Additionally, also that you know, the decision to shut down the company was not unilateral. It was taken after an approval by Majestic Infracon. Back to you.
Right, Avantika, thanks for all those updates there as to what we're tracking in terms of their developments there as far as those factors are concerned. But, you know, Avantika, when we talk about some of the other factors here as well, take us to the Bombay High Court ruling as well as what you picked up in that context.
Well, the Bombay High Court has admitted the winding up petition. They have stated that currently the liabilities of the company are far in excess of its assets. They don't really see the company standing on its feet again. They've also stated that the revival scheme that was submitted by Majestic Infracon did not really look viable. They've stated that, you know, some of the prospects of future investors have not really been explained. Also, that the entire grounds of the revival scheme seems to be based on this winding up petition being taken back, which is like unlikely to happen. But the court has added that if the company can come up with a viable renewal scheme, they are free to submit it to the court and the court could consider it.